a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. It is a period of civil war. Rebel spaceships, striking from a hidden base, have won their first victory against the evil Galactic Empire.
What are you doing?
The opening, why?
That's not in our script. That's the Star Wars opening.
Well, I thought it sounded familiar, but if it's not in the script, then why is it on the paper I'm supposed to read?
I don't know, but it's not supposed to be there. Skip to the next part.
Fine,
Earth. Fire. Air. Water.
Avocado?
No, that's still not it.
It's in the script, Julia. It says it right here, look. Can we get a paper sound effect here?
This isn't the copy I gave you. Where did you get this?
Peter gave it to me. He said that we'd decided to make a few changes to the script.
I'm going to kill him. Let me look at this for a moment. We're starting here.
okay, I got it. In the beginning, Miss Nation created the ink blot.
Now you're just doing it on purpose. Miss Nation, can you do it, please?
Well, we just had to think of a name.
Hey, everybody, we need to think of the name of our new YouTube channel. Anybody got any ideas?
I think we should call it the Green Hope Gazette. We gotta have school spirit, guys.
Right, now, I'm just spitballing here, but what about Right What's Right?
Michelle, would you like to say something?
What about madness behind creativity?
I think we should call it the Falcon Swoop. Kind of like the Scoop, but with the Falcon. And we can make a swoop like the logo.
That's just like the Nike symbol. Our tagline ought to be just write it.
I think we could get sued for that, guys. Let's stay away from anything that even seems remotely like stealing copyrighted material from a multi-million dollar company.
Guys, I know what we should call it. The Ink Blot.
There you have it, the very beginning of the Ink Blot. Of course, not soon after, the Great Web Quest began.
Class, we must create a web quest so that the Creative Writing 1 students will be able to follow in our footsteps. Most of you will be working on that. The graphic design team, however, has to come up with images be used on our YouTube channel. You know your assignments. Begin.
What? You honestly thought we would be working?
So what do you have up here? Like, okay, can we use that? Do we have enough time to even do that?
I was trying to make it.
I miss happiness. Our stress about the assignment by doing all using the internet for alternative uses of cat videos. It'll be done. It's fine. I'm fine. It'll be fine. It's fine. It's fine.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I got my work done 3 days ago.
New assignment.
Hi, my name is Lester Bolt from Baseline GHHS. Today we're going to be delving into the brutal massacre that was the first playlist. And like the birth of every playlist, at first there is a pitch meeting. The first pitch meeting took place on October 12th, 2015. During this debate, themes that were talked about were sadness, depression, and even death, but friendship as well. Eventually, the theme that was decided upon was new beginnings. This theme crashed and burned, furiously, like a plane falling out of the sky. Let's talk to our friend Claire to hear more about it. So it says here that at the beginning of every playlist, you had a young gal by the name of Carrie Eskridge giving little blurbs and whatnot for each video. How was that?
Well, Carrie was in every single video. Click on any one of them, you'll find her.
Okay, well, it also says that you were the filming expert, so what was it like behind the scenes?
It was a nightmare, all right? Every day, every time I'd go, Carrie would just scream at me. Just for no reason.
No, this is all wrong. This is my show. I'm the one in charge. I'm the host. I am the star.
Okay? Oh. Okay?
tired. Look at my face.
I'm looking.
It's too beautiful not to. I'm the host. Love me.
Good evening. We have M here to talk about the short story Fresh Meat, which was the last video from the first playlist. So, were there any problems you faced in this story's creation?
There were, in fact. You know, we used to be a class of 24, but then Bob took one for the team and we became a class of 23. We didn't know which medium we were going to use to turn this short story into a video, and before we settled on using Reader's Theater, we're going to full out act it out with lines and everything. So Bob had to die for authenticity. You know, he was a really good guy. He tasted good too, but at least he'll rest easy knowing he got 100% for participation. Love you, Bob.
I think it's time for the next work. I heard that Jack's poem was a piece that really tugged at everyone's heartstrings. Can you elaborate? I was curious. Everyone was a part of it, so what did you...
I'm sorry, it's just, this piece, it was just so beautiful, and, you know, we're all just best friends, and we all love each other, and we work so well together, it's just really...
Can you please get a grip on yourself? I'm trying to conduct an interview.
I'm sorry, can I just have a minute?
Let's just cut to the next work, shall we? So Jenga, there was some pretty deep metaphorical stuff in this one. What was filming this like?
Well, for starters, writers aren't the most talented Jenga players. Every time we need to just take a shot of the tower, someone would come along and knock it over. Every freaking time.
Well, that sounds like a very towering problem you've got there.
Yeah, Lester, it was. And sometimes, it would knock over when no one was around. I think that it might have been possessed.
Okay. Well, that was a spotlight on four of our videos from the first playlist. Now we are going to go back to some of the first stories we remember and love. Fairy tales.
I'm Carrie Eskridge, Rider Dial Hunter. This time, our dials are in their fairy tale season. They've been working hard. Now remember to stay quiet and not to spook them. Let's get started. Now we are going to approach some of the Fairy Tale 451 writer dials. You will notice how they work in a group well, but they are easily spooked by noises. So, we are going to try and meet one, but let's not spook them.
Hey guys.
Well, we're coming up on a rider dial during the filming process. Let's see if we can get a closer look.
What are you doing?
As you can see here, here are the fingers that typed this lovely, lovely script.
I'm trying to film a video.
And you see, she has her camera set up. You can tell this rider dial knows what she's doing.
Okay, if you don't get out of here, I'm going
And you can also see she is a little agitated, so I think we should go now. the multi-talented variety of the Rider Dial. As you can see, this one here is probably one of the largest of its kind in the world. You see here, you can tell this Rider Dial by his distinctive hairstyles and the plethora of equipment he lugs around. Oh, well, isn't this a treat? We have another Rider Dial coming. We can see how they interact. Here, they are doing their traditional ritual to gain till they hit each other until one of them gets an
idea.
And now this poor Rider Dial is left all alone. As you can see, he tries to complete the ritual himself, but unfortunately, most of the time it won't work. Here we have a Rider Dial who seems to have given up, and he has shielded himself from the outside world with the headphones and the hoodie.
I can still hear you, you know.
I'm sorry. Now come on, sweetheart. Stand up. Someone's gonna step on you if you don't get up and pull yourself together.
I don't care.
Oh, come on then. What's wrong?
Everything around is horrible.
That's not true. Don't you remember that arsonist play that you... I mean, don't you remember that... the thing you did for the New Beginnings playlist, you and Alexia. It was beautiful, one of my favorites.
You really think so?
I do. Now, come on then, let's go. Let's go, yeah. You can do it.
Cool. So I was thinking that maybe the next line could be, take to the skies where you're given the gift of flight.
I kind of like it, but I feel like we should make it more fairy-like at one point.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
Yeah. Match with
Crikey, mate. I think we found ourselves a wild. Kathy and Ada in their natural habitat. Let's get a closer look.
Harry, what are you doing?
Jiminy Cricket, we've been spotted. Here we have some vacuum thermoses that have been collected over the past few days as the Rider Dials have been working. This substance helps keep them awake and alert, even if they haven't had enough sleep for the week. And what is this? A Rider Dial is coming. Let's hide. That Rider Dial will protect her thermos with her life. As you can see, they're very important to these creatures. And what is this? A second Rider Dial? Did we just get a treat? That was the supreme Rider Dial coming to stake her claim on a thermos as well. I'd say this was a very successful show, folks. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Carrie Eskridge, the Rider Dial Hunter.
We're in the wilderness, as you can see. Very, very cold, very natural. As far as the ink blot, never really thought it would take me as far as it did. It was really, really amazing. Yeah, never thought I'd be able to combine my love of filmmaking and writing to create some great, great pieces. Here we have some natives. They don't interact with you much, so I gotta forage my own food. But yeah, I made some really amazing, which is pretty good. Really amazing stuff. It's good wilderness food. I mean, watching my pieces, you know, come to life was amazing. Never thought I'd be able to do that with the inkblot. Am I doing this right?
I never in the entire world imagined that the inkblot would become such a huge hit.
How wrong was I? The whole dystopia thing was really an uprising, along with the two other themes. I loved writing about zombie apocalypses and black holes because I could really make up any crazy ideas I wanted to. I could really put a small level of creativity I had into writing this dystopia theme.
I had doubts about the whole dystopia thing, leaving people on a bad note, but my fears were dissipated as much of the content for this final playlist was comical, but related to the theme of dystopia.
I was honestly a little bit nervous that we would end up ending our entire channel on a really sad note with this dystopian playlist, but it was actually really great because we had a variety of different videos. We had some sad, some were really creepy, and some were even humorous and lighthearted, like Alex, for example, stunned us all again with his rhyming, non-metaphorical poem. And I mean, I think it was one of the best, if not the best, playlists on our channel.
I thought that the inkblot would be only something that the students taking the class would find cool, not something that we could share with everyone. But fortunately, I was wrong. Now I know that the inkblot is actually a creative, high-quality production where the students of Green Hope get to show off their writing skills and share that with the world through the platform YouTube.
To make people sad. Success!
Hey guys, I'm Ada.
I'm Michelle.
I'm Zoe.
Hope you enjoyed the first part of our very last video for Green Hope's Inkblot. We've been part of the editorial board for it.
Coming up is our advice to future creative writing students using only 6 words.
Keep on writing and hope you enjoy.
Bye!
Thank you.
attract everyone's attention.
I thought it was okay. I think it's recording, but I don't know how to stop it.